contract negotiations leading up to the tentative agreement that IATSE members will be voting on this weekend were unlike any that had come before. Conducted after the film and TV industry roared back to life from the darkest days of the pandemic, the giant media conglomerates came to the bargaining table demanding a wide range of rollbacks in pay and benefits, which the union successfully thwarted after members, for the first time ever, voted. It was a very difficult round, as evidenced by the fact that we were forced to take a strike vote to get the employers to move on our key issues. He added, "I think there were several reasons for all this. First, you have the fact that the industry has seen a good deal of consolidation over the last few years. We are now negotiating with people who are representing large media corporations versus studios and production companies. And of course, we can't leave out Disney Studios and Fox with their multi-billion dollar merger. Along with these companies' march on mergers and acquisitions, came the challenges and difficulties of negotiating with them." Davis, who is urging members to ratify the contract, cited several rollbacks proposed by the companies. "We had to fight back employer attacks," he wrote. "As we entered negotiations, the employers demanded that hours required for a qualified pension year be more than doubled. They proposed that in order to shorten the workday, they be allowed to work us 11 hours straight without a meal break without paying any meal penalties. They proposed wage increases of 1%, with no increase or modification of streaming. They proposed that what remains of night premiums be eliminated." He noted, however, that after nearly 99% of the voting members voted to authorize a strike, all of the company's proposals were rejected and ultimately withdrawn. Instead of 1% pay raises, the tentative agreement calls for 3% annual pay hikes retroactive to August 1, 2021.